Hey guys, Ravi here, and this is the best development board that I have ever used. Called the M5Stack, this tiny module has an ESP32, a 2-inch color LCD, a 1-watt speaker, a battery, a microSD card reader, and 3 built-in buttons. Of course, since it has an ESP32 as a brain, it has Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and all the other cool stuff that comes with it. But what makes this module so awesome is not what's in it, but how it all has been packaged. The whole thing is a 5 cm square of hard plastic all around with an acrylic front. The left side has the power/reset button, the USB-C port, and a groove-compatible I2C breakout. The right side has the speaker grill, while the bottom has the microSD card slot. Now, you might have noticed the array of headers on all sides of the module that I haven't addressed yet. This is where the largest selling point of the M5 comes in. The device is meant to be modular or stackable, as they are calling it, so you can swap out the bottom for different modules for different functionality. The default configuration that it comes with is this bottom that extends the ESP32's GPIO to female headers on the bottom and left and into male headers on the top and right. While this is good enough for quick breadboard work, you can go way, way more advanced than that. To get you started, they give you this protoboard that comes in the box. I made this gamepad controller to play the game of Snake that I wrote, but the creators of the board have featured a ton of really cool modules like a full QWERTY keyboard, a thermal camera, a relay module, a bigger, better speaker, an oscilloscope, a LoRa module, a SIM module, a GPS, a whole car, and surely much more is to come. But in my opinion, it's just better and more fun to make your own modules, and you can take it a step further and make it more professional by getting your own custom PCBs from glcpcb.com for only $2. They currently have free shipping that you should definitely take advantage of to take your projects to the next level. Now, back to the M5. I have been playing with this thing for a few months now and I'm thoroughly impressed with it. Having a screen on board is a complete godsend for debugging. The library for the M5 allows for easily controlling the screen, using the speaker, taking inputs from buttons, and reading the microSD card. In the time that I have had it, I have done a few experiments. Controlling other microcontrollers, writing a game for it, using it as a clock, and even used it as a NES emulator. Everything that I have tried has worked flawlessly, and having a battery and the whole thing being self-contained is such a huge convenience that I don't know how I lived without it. Last but definitely not the least is the newly released web IDE for MicroPython that is so much faster to work with than the Arduino IDE. So I have no problem in wholeheartedly recommending it to anyone. The $35 price tag seems a bit much at first, but I think the features and quality of the product completely justifies the price. It's not all sunshine and roses though. I do have a few minor complaints. The first being the speaker. The sound quality is as much as you can expect from a tiny 1-watt speaker, but what I noticed is that even when nothing is playing on it, there is a constant hum that's there. It's very quiet and almost inaudible and can be easily ignored. I don't think the microphone can even pick it up, but it's still annoying in quiet environments and definitely no good for the battery life. Speaking of which, the built-in battery is very small, like absolutely tiny, only 150 milliamps. It barely lasts a couple of hours. Thankfully, you can plug your own battery like I have done here with the gamepad module, which lasts much longer. On the software side, the Arduino libraries are nicely polished, but I really prefer working with the MicroPython instead on the account of it being significantly faster to prototype with. But since that is in beta, the documentation is lacking and the interpreter is missing a couple of features. But regardless, these are minor complaints that I am sure would be fixed with time. There are also some little details I noticed that I really appreciate, like how the back is magnetic and the top also has this place for stickers that came in the box to help you differentiate between multiple of these. Which is a really good thing in my opinion, since I can't remember which of my nanos blinks a LED and which one is a doomsday device. Again, I really like this tiny little thing. It's compact, feature-packed, expandable, easy to work with, and it gets my full recommendation. I'll definitely be using it in some of my future projects. Let me know in the comments below what you would like to see me use this for next. Leave a like if you can spare a second, and do subscribe if you want to see me put this thing through its paces in the future. Also, check out glcpcb.com. They make high quality PCBs for really cheap.